guy. I don't handle spices very well, so here we go. I don't want to do this.
Okay, look at this one. It looks pretty big. Can you see it? Alright, I'm gonna take this off the butt. Put it down. And I'm just gonna chew it.
Here we go. Thoughts? Or do you want to just keep chewing? No.
Okay, I just swallowed it. Let's start reading. His long fingers reach around to gently massage my clitoris, circling slowly. His breath is soft against my face as he slowly nips me along his jaw.
You smell divine, he nuzzles. Nuzzles me out. I'm not here, Jesus. I was not expecting this. Nuzzles me out my jaw. You smell divine. He rubs his hand against me, round and round. Reflexively,
my hips start to circle, mirroring his hands. As excruciating pain, oh hell yeah, pleasure spikes through my blood like adrenaline. Keep still, he orders, his voice soft but urgent. And slowly, he inserts his thumb inside me, rotating it round and round, stroking.
Don't rub your eyes. Don't do that. There you go.
Stroking the front wall of my vagina.
Yeah, I don't handle spices very well. Am I crying? I feel like I'm crying. The effect is mind-blowing. All my energy concentrating on this one small space inside my body. I moan. You like this? He asks softly. His teeth grazing my outer ear. And he starts to flex his thumb slowly in and out, in and out. His fingers still circling. I close my eyes. Can't feel any of my mouth just burn. That's all I can feel is burn.
He acts softly, his teeth grazing my outer ear. And he starts to flex his thumb slowly in and out, his fingers still circling. I close my eyes. Trying to keep my breath, my breathing under control, trying to absorb the disordered, chaotic sensation that his fingers are unleashing on me. Fire cursing through my body. I moan again. You're so wet. So quickly. So responsive.
You got this?
Oh, Anastasia. I like that a lot.
Where was I in this great story? I'm unaffected by this. I don't even feel it. I woke up like this. Oh man. Unaffected, completely unfazed. I feel nothing.
Oh. I'm so regretting this.
Really?
Naughty, sweet girl, he whispers, and then reaches over. This is so fucking hot. And he, where am I? And he reaches over to the bedside table for a full packet. Stay still, don't move, he orders as he releases more. I can't even speak, dude. As he releases my hair.
He rips the foil while I'm breathing hard. My body singing in my veins. The anticipation is exhilarating. He leans down, his weight on mine. He grabs me, grabs my hair, holding my head immobile. Oh, God. I cannot move. I'm enticingly ensnared by him. He's poised, ready to take me once more. We're going to go real slow this time, Anastasia, he breathes. And slowly he eases into me, slowly, slowly until he's buried in me. Stretching, filling, relentless. I groan loudly. It feels deeper this time, delectable. I groan. I still had seeds in my mouth.
And my inside starts to quiver. He pulls back and waits. Oh no, baby, not yet. He murmurs, I can't even say the word. And as the quivering ceases, he starts the whole delicious process again.
Oh please, I beg. I'm not sure I can take much more. My body is wound so tight, craving release. I want you sore, baby. He murmurs, and as he continues his sweet, leisurely torment, backward, forward.
Every time you move tomorrow, I want you to remind me that I've been here. Only me, you are mine.
I groan. Please, Christian, I whisper. What do you want, Anastasia? Tell me. I groan again. He pulls out and moves slowly back into me, circling his hips once more. Tell me, he murmurs. You, please.
He increases the rhythm infinitesimally, and his breathing becomes more erratic. My inside starts quivering, and Kristen picks up the rhythm. You are so sweet, he murmurs between each thrust. I want you so much, I moan. You're mine. Come for me, baby, he growls.
His words are undoing, tipping me over the precipice. My body convulses around him, and I come, loudly, calling out a garbled version of his name into the mattress. Christian follows me with two sharp thrusts, and still he freezes, pouring himself into me as he finds his release. He collapses on top of me, his face in my hair.
Fuck, Anna. He breathes. He pulls out of me. Immediately, and rolls onto his side. Onto his side of the bed. I pull my knees up to my chest, utterly spent. Dude, I can't speak. Utterly spent, and immediately drift off or passed out into an exhausted sleep.
When I wake, it's still dark. I have no idea how long I've slept. I stretch out beneath the duvet. I feel so sore, deliciously sore. Christian is nowhere to be seen. I sit up, staring out at the cityscape in front of me.
There are fewer lights amongst the skyscrapers, and there's a whisper of dawn in the east. I hear the music.
The lilting notes of a piano, a sad, sweet lament. Bach, I think, but I'm not sure. My name is Seth. And that's the Ghost Chili Challenge.
You still recommend it?
I mean...
Because you were crying for a little bit there.
Yeah. When it gets intense, it gets intense.
As a disclosure, I want to say we saw this on the Sundays Fun Days page, and we're kind of reenacting what they did. It was really impressive. Well, impressively funny. Sundays Fun Days. Check them out.
It's actually Friday.
It's Friday.
Alright. Yeah.
You have the choice right now to determine if you've won the challenge. Do you want a beer or do you want milk?
Beer?
Can you handle it?
Not right now, maybe in 30 minutes.
I'll take a beer. And that's story time. 50 Shades of Grey. That was easy. I woke up like this. My tears running down my face. Feels like there's tears all over my face. I can't read right now. Oh my god, everything is swollen inside of me. This is not part of the story, it's just like... I feel like I can faint any second, honestly.
Really? It gets better, trust me.
I trust you. My Nubian brother.